the emotional hearing for David and Louise Turpin, sentenced after pleading guilty to 14 charges, including torture, for holding 12 of their children captive for years, even shackling them to beds. Louise Turpin, you see her there, breaking down, hearing what some of her children had to say. Now, the Turpins could spend the rest of their lives behind bars. Here's ABC's chief national correspondent, Matt Gutman.
The last time the Turpin children saw their parents, some were shackled to their beds.
My parents took my whole life from me.
But today, in court, resilience.
Now I'm taking my life back.
David and Louise Turpin sobbing as they listened to statements from four of their children. And before a judge sentenced them to 25 to life for what they did to their own.
Sometimes I still have nightmares of things that had happened, such as my siblings being chained up or getting beaten. But that is the past, and this is now.
A remarkable turn from January 2018, when their 17-year-old sister scrambled out this window to dial 911.
My parents are abusing, they abuse us, and my two little sisters right now are chained up.
Where are they chained up at?
On their bed.
Seen here being arrested, both pleaded guilty to multiple counts, accused of torturing 12 of their 13 children, starving them, keeping them in filth, even beating some. And amid their children's expressions of anger, there was also forgiveness.
I love my parents and have forgiven them for a lot of the things that they did to us.
David Turpin so overcome that at first he was unable to read his statement. His wife Louise more remorseful.
I want to say again how truly sorry I am for everything I've done to hurt them. I love them more than they could ever imagine.
But the judge had little pity.
To the extent that they do thrive, it will be not because of you both, but in spite of
a powerful day in court there. Matt Gutman joins us now live. Matt, this case is now over, but those children have a long recovery ahead of them.
And Tom, that's partly because years of chronic malnutrition left many of them physically stunted. Now, it took incredible courage for those two siblings to go into that courtroom and read that statement today. And their attorney tells me that five of them, though, are now in college. One of them has his first part-time job in a bike shop. Tom.
Incredible courage and now some incredible resilience. All right, Matt, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.